Hello, children. We have a story for you titled Peter the Field Mouse. So if you're all sitting nice and comfortable, then I'll begin. It was early in the morning, and Peter the Field Mouse had got up very early to look around for some food, as he always did, nearly every day. Peter the Field Mouse lived in the middle of a large field, which was situated close by to a really big zoo. Peter the Field Mouse would visit the zoo every day, crawling under a tall fence to see if he could pick up some scraps of food left all around the zoo by the people that visited there. But Peter the Field Mouse had to be careful where he went and stayed away from the lions and the tigers' cages, or he might end up on their menu for lunch. One day, Peter the Field Mouse spooked a great big elephant, who ran off quite frightened, and Peter the Field Mouse could never understand why such a great big elephant would do that, being that he was such a tiny little field mouse. And that's all that Peter the Field Mouse was, a mouse, who nobody ever really looked at, not like all the other animals in the zoo. And sometimes Peter the Field Mouse dreamed of being a tiger or a lion or even a penguin. Then perhaps somebody might notice him. Like most days, Peter the Field Mouse was scurrying around looking for food in the reptile house. And a zookeeper happened to see him and picked Peter the Field Mouse up by his long tail and placed him inside a cage with wooden bars on it and left him there. Peter the Field Mouse didn't like very much being inside a cage and started biting away at one of the wooden bars. After a few hours of biting and pushing and using his body, he finally removed one of the wooden bars and slowly squeezed himself out of the cage. But it was already dark outside the reptile house. Peter the Field Mouse managed to get down onto the floor and ran towards the great big door of the reptile house, but it was closed tight. Peter then scurried around here and there, trying to find another way out. After a few hours of searching around, Peter the Field Mouse couldn't find a way out, so decided to sit and wait until somebody opened the door of the reptile house. After another few hours of waiting, somebody came and opened the door, and Peter the Field Mouse ran as fast as he could outside into the morning sunshine. Peter Field Mouse hobbled here and hobbled there and all around, and eventually found his way out of the zoo, finding a few scraps of food on the way to take home with him. Peter the Field Mouse finally found his field once again and met Moppy Mouse, who was on his way to the zoo. Peter the Field Mouse explained what had happened to him, but Moppy Mouse was not really interested in Peter the Field Mouse's fantastic story and carried on as he usually did on his way to the zoo. Peter the Field Mouse found his hole and was happy to be nice and safely back home again. Peter the Field Mouse sat in his bed and decided he was quite happy to be just a plain old field mouse, whom nobody ever looked at, and also decided he never ever wanted to live in a cage like the lions and the tigers did, as he liked his freedom and thought how nasty it must be to be locked up all day and night in a cage. Peter the Field Mouse was happy then that he was not the star attraction in the zoo and didn't, after his small adventure, want to be really noticed by anybody at all, and fell fast asleep dreaming of a large lump of cheese instead. Thank you for listening, children. Until next time, goodbye.